At 9:25 p.m. local time on August 22, 2024, a new volcanic eruption began at Iceland's Reykjanes volcano, which is located approximately 37 kilometers southwest of the capital city Reykjavik. As a result, the town of Grindavik, the Svartsengi geothermal power plant, and the Blue Lagoon were all quickly evacuated. What initially started out as a sudden jump in visible gas emissions soon gave way to the eruption of lava. The associated fissure then unzipped both to the north and south, causing large volumes of lava to erupt. As the eruption intensified, the fissure thankfully seems to have dominantly expanded to the northeast rather than the southwest, reaching 1, then 2, then 3, and finally 4 kilometers in length. As the eruption continued to intensify, lava fountains along this entire length, equivalent to about 13,000 feet, was all effusing lava at a combined rate of what I estimated to be 1,300 cubic meters per second. As lava fountains, which reached 30 to 40 meters in height, fell back to the ground, four separate lobes of fluid basaltic lava advanced to the west, and by 2 hours later were only 200 meters away from the lava barriers protecting the Svartsengi geothermal power plant and the Blue Lagoon. Lava is still actively flowing in this direction at a decent speed, so I fully expect both northward-facing roads and an associated hot water pipe to soon be covered by fresh lava. It only took 120 minutes for 3 square kilometers to be covered in a layer of molten rock, but the good news is that like all other Reykjanes eruptive episodes, the eruption starts with a high intensity but then continuously declines thereafter. This is why we are already witnessing declining lava fountain heights. Because the eruptive fissure is staying clear of the taller regional subglacial hills and mounds, this means that, in my opinion, explosive activity for now is quite unlikely. Therefore, this eruption should absolutely not disrupt air traffic across Iceland or other parts of Europe. Early on in this eruption, various webcams provided great views of what appeared to be a small-scale lava fall which rapidly sped up molten rock which flowed over it. I have geolocated this feature to a crater row which was in place by eruptions 8 centuries ago, with lava merely falling down prior several meter-high spatter cones. The blue gas you are seeing in the plume shows that high levels of sulfur dioxide are present, as although you cannot see this gas directly, its molecules do scatter light to give this hue. Toxic levels of this gas are currently blowing to the south directly over the town of Grindavik, which is another reason the area is closed off to everyone. Despite the correct assertion that this eruption is already waning, I fully expect it to last for at least another week. My reasoning? Simply put, the lead-up to the current eruption involved more magma pooling at depth than any of its 5 prior eruptions since December of last year, specifically around 30 million cubic meters of magma pooled. However, in the last 2 eruptions, far more than what pooled in this magma chamber ended up erupting, as an unobstructed pathway exists from a deep magma reservoir to the surface. Also, further northward expansions of the eruptive fissure could still occur, as shown by the magnitude 4.2 earthquake which struck due to the subsurface expansion of this very dike. So, in summary, lava is not currently flowing south towards the town of Grindavik, but rather west towards the Svartsengi geothermal power plant in the Blue Lagoon. Thankfully, these areas are protected by lava walls, and in all likelihood, these lava walls will hold. This eruption involves more magma but seemingly had an initial lower eruptive rate than the prior 2 eruptions in March and May. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Cindy Spear for supporting this YouTube channel.